You read that right. We know him for his points and passes, but the big, slow and unathletic Nikola Jokic is an elite defender. Or at least that's what the advanced NBA stats tell us. Nuggets center has the clear number one defensive rating in the team and occupies fourth position in defensive win shares category between all the centers in the league, only with defensive beasts like Gobert and the Cavs duo Jared Allen and Evan Mobley in front. So how a player who is far away from being one of the most athletic guys is an elite defender in the league full of them? BasketNews.com decided to investigate this topic and understand if the stats and the video material are telling the same story.
I went at Jokic's defense. I'm like, if they're going to ever be a good team, he's the back line of the defense. He has to be good defensively. And I show four clips, him not rotating over as the low man, him not moving. Four clips. And I was very critical of him. He came up to me that following year and he said, hey, I saw what you said about my defense or something. You were right. Or I appreciate it or something right. He said like that. And he said, I've gotten better. I said, you 100% gotten better. I've been watching you this year and you've 100% gotten better.
Throughout the big man's career, we became used to the fact that he is a defensive liability on the court. In the regular season, there were good and bad games, but the playoffs always exposed the weak part of his game. When it mattered, he was the number one target for the opposing teams, which obsessively tried to involve Nikola Jokic as much as possible. Slow feet and bad lateral movement left Nuggets coach Michael Malone with no choice but to use passive pick-and-roll defense with Jokic, even against opponents with superstar guards like Lillard, McCollum, Booker, or Paul. Jokic playing drop meant these players got all the freedom they wanted. All they needed to do was to get their man into the screen. Drop defense gives away the mid-range shot, in theory the most ineffective one, but for these names it's like a layup. Switching also was never an option. On ISOs, Jokic was left far away behind by explosive guards and even by lesser known names like Cameron Payne. There was too much space between the reigning MVP and his closest defenders, so the quicker guards had no trouble beating him on rare isolation plays. And on pick and rolls, who happened every two possessions, the problems were always the same, whichever tactic Nuggets chose for Jokic, dropping low or playing flat a little higher. Either the guard was too quick and beat both the guard and Jokic, or Nikola find himself in a gray zone, in the middle between two opponents. This resulted in extremely too many easy buckets from the paint. You can find 2, 3, 4 and even 5 clips like this in every game. Don't be surprised when you notice a similar situation this season though, but it happens on a much rarer occasion. So if the Nuggets didn't change their defensive tactics with Jokic, what influenced such a difference in MVP's defensive numbers? Before going into detail about that, let me present to you the sponsor of this video, NordVPN. Do not miss any match, even if you are abroad. With NordVPN, you can change your virtual location with a click and take advantage of the fastest VPN on the market. That's not all. Just click on the link in the description or type in nordvpn.com/basketanalytics and you will get 73% off the 2-year plan. And even that's not all. If you are not satisfied, you can get your money back within the first 30 days. That's nordvpn.com/basketanalytics. Watching Nuggets games from both this and last season, at first I couldn't really understand and explain this change in Jokic numbers. Same choices by Malone, similar ratio between drop and flat. But after seeing this help from the weak side by Michael Porter Jr., it became clear that Nikola's weakness on pick and rolls was not only his fault. Yes, Jokic is average at best individual defender, but what if his teammates last year didn't help at all to cover that up, and even worse, made it look terrible? This year it's different. Nuggets seem to be working more as a unit. On this pin down into hand of action attacking Jokic, look at Morris ready to close the gap for driving inside, Gordon doing the rear view contest and Green tagging the rolling Nurkic. There is no space for McCollum to drive, leaving him with the only option to pass out to Covington, only a 34% shooter from deep this year. Against teams like Portland and Atlanta, you can feel the responsibility from Nikola's teammates to not leave him too alone on pick and roll defense, players stunned from one pass away when needed, and the on-ball defenders maximize their efforts on pressuring the handler from behind. This is another thing worth noticing, rear view contest when Jokic is playing drop. Success of pick and roll defense depends not only on Jokic's ability, but also on the guard. If he is taking too long to get out from the screen, or gets pinned every single time, that's a problem. But when you have such long players like Gordon or Porter Jr. defending the ball, their interview contest will almost always be there. Porter, when healthy, was a huge part of Denver's defensive success. The numbers illustrate that perfectly well. In October, when Michael was still playing, Jokic's defensive numbers were the best. His individual defensive rating was simply amazing. Porter was good on the ball, but just superb as a low-man defender. When Jokic went higher to play flat or even double, Porter was on time with rotations, and with his long arms bothered shots for opposing centers. This clip is proof of his defensive growth. He is shadowing the role man, and even with a magical Lucas pass, reacts to make a huge leap and contest a shot. Last season, this would have probably been an easy layup for Powell, with no help from the weak side. This year, we are more likely to see two people coming to help, and at least forcing the ball to get in the basket from 7 meters away.
Yeah, Sacramento trying to drive in. There's Jokic, that man again. Jokic with the block shot, his second tonight. Oh!
Obviously, Nikola's numbers are so high not only because of his teammates. His use of hands often creates unexpected problems for guards whenever they become a bit careless with the ball. Drop is still the most used pick and roll tactic, as Jokic stays really deep in the area waiting for guards to make a decision. If they think too much and concentrate on their own defenders, Nikola is quick enough to slap the ball away. Other times, he is provoking a mid-range shot for those NBA players that aren't that comfortable, and more importantly, efficient on these shots. Eric Bledsoe, please take as many as you want of these. Miles Bridges, you are welcome too. Defending like this permits Jokic to protect the rim and avoid allowing easy layups. Against these deep drops, popping big after the screen is a powerful weapon, but not when the Nuggets execute another little detail that can be easily missed. Okay, so Jokic drops, allows mid-range, and Rivers does the rear view contest. As soon as the two realize that Ibaka pops here, look at them communicating to execute the so-called peel switch, where Rivers just picks up Ibaka. The difference from the simple switch is that it is not automatic and done only when the big doesn't roll. Peel switch negates a major counter tactic teams have against drop. Whatever the choice might be on pick and roll defense, Jokic finishes off the defensive sequence with a box out. He is number one in box outs made per game in all NBA. I guess that's the price you have to pay when your opponents jump much higher than you. He is second in rebounds per game and takes 11.5 of them on defense, allowing a small amount of second chance points, which helps his defensive rating, and immediately starting the fast break. And is it only me or these one-handed tipping rebounds to himself are so fun to watch? That's it. Now you know the real reason Jokic numbers on defense are elite. Merit belongs not only to him, but to the whole team. Michael Malone does a great job keeping players accountable and reminding them that defending pick and roll is not only a two-man job, especially in the NBA, where the game is super spaced out. Nikola is having an unreal season, and it will be interesting to see if defensive improvements allow him to win the MVP trophy again. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below, and I'll see you in the next video.